Good morning, students.
Hi, this is Siddhant Jain. So today we will discuss about the laws of exponents and all the theory about exponents. First of all, our today's lecture is on exponents. Now, basically, as the name suggests, exponents means any number termed in terms of power. I repeat, exponent means any number which is termed in terms of power. Now, this 2 raised to the power 1 by 2 can also be written as root 2. So, this root 2 shows the radical sign. This root 2 is in the form of radical sign, and this 2 whole raised to the power 1 by 2 is in the form of exponents. So, till now we have understood about what are exponents. Exponents are the terms which are termed in terms of powers. For example, if we say any number take as 32 whole raised to the power 1 by 7. So, this means that 32 whole raised to the power 1 by 7 is in the terms of exponents, shows that 32 1 by 7 is in the form of power. So, this whole term is in the form of exponents. So, basically this term 32 whole raised to the power 1 by 7 can also be written as 32, this is 7th root of 32 and which is in radical sign form. Now again we'll start with some other examples. For example, 79 whole raised to the power 79 upon 35. So, this whole term which is written as 79 whole raised to the power 79 upon 35 is in the term of exponent form. So, exponent form is always termed in the form of power form. Now, to go to the next topic, which we have to understand first of all the very basic important concept about the laws of exponents. First of all, we will understand about what are the laws of exponents. This laws of exponent forms the basic example of your life, because these laws of exponents are asked in many NTSC exams also and many CBSE exams also. So we understand about all the laws of exponents. Now to start with the first law, we will start with the first law of exponent. That is, first law is, let's take a number as x raised to the power m multiply by x raised to the power n is equals to x raised to the power m plus n. Implies that if base is same, this x is the base and this m and n are the powers, implies that if x is the same, means if the base is the same, then the power gets added. We will understand these laws of exponent with some more examples, but first of all you must write all these laws in your separate copy. Now the second laws of the exponent is, when both this base are divided having the same base but the different power, implies that x to the power m divided by x to the power n is equals to x to the power m minus n. Now moving on to the third law, we'll understand each and every law of exponent separately, but first of all we will write all the laws. The third law is, when base is different but the power is same. In first law we have seen that base is same but the powers are different. In the third law, base is different but the powers are same, implies that this x and y is the base and this power m shows the index of the base. This x is the base, this y is also the base, and दिस एम इंप्लाइज टू द इंडेक्स कॉमा पावर वी कैन टर्म्ड एम एस बोथ इंडेक्स ऑफ पावर बोथ इंप्लाइज द सेम थिंग इंप्लाइज दैट एक्स टू द पावर एम इंटू वाई टू द पावर एम गिव्स यू द आंसर एज एक्स इंटू वाई होल रेज टू द पावर एम नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज लॉ नंबर फोर लॉ नंबर फोर सेज व्हेन बोथ द बेस हैविंग द सेम पावर आर डिवाइडेड बोथ द बेस हैविंग द सेम पावर बट द डिफरेंट बेस आर डिवाइडेड इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स अपॉन वाई इट दिस पावर comes in the whole power m form and this x upon y to the power m gives you the exponent form of the x upon y rational number. So we understand this also in a separate topic. First of all, move to the next law, that is law number 5 implies that x to the power m and this whole raised to the power n is equals to x to the power m multiplied by n is equals to x to the power mn. This law basically means that if any number is having a power m, for example, we will understand this law with an example. Let's take a number as 7 raised to the power 3 and this whole expression is also termed the power of 2 implies that 7 raised to the power 3 into 2 is equals to 7 raised to the power 6 is the answer. So x to the power n is equals to x to the power m into n implies that when base is having certain power which is m and then again the base is having a certain power which is n implies that both the powers get multiplied and we get the answer. Now moving to the last law, that is law number 6, which is x to the power 0 is always 1. Always remember this law. This is a very important and a very basic law of the exponents chapter. X to the power 0, x is any real number except 0. X is any real number minus 0. And the base can be any real number where and m is any real number. So basically, if any real number except 0 is a given power 0, which shows that power is always 1. So always check that the base should not be equal to 0, because if the base becomes 0, then 0 raised to the power is an indeterminate form which is cannot be true or which cannot be solved using simple mathematical operations. So always check that base should not be 0 in any case. Power can be 0 but base cannot be equal to 0. Now we will understand each and every law with certain examples. So first of all, moving to the next two types of questions, that is how to solve these type of problems. First law was, now we will understand each and every law within certain examples. First of all, we will check example number 1 explaining us the first law of exponent. Now the first law of exponent was x to the power m multiplied by x to the power n is equals to x to the power m plus n. So implies that x to the power m into x to the power n is equals to x to the power m plus n. Take an example as 29 raised to the power 11 multiplied by 29 raised to the power 7. Now check that base should not be equals to 0. I repeat, base should not be equals to 0. This is our base which should not be equals to 0 implies that is equals to 29 raised to the power 11 into 29 raised to the power 7 gives you the answer as 29 raised to the power, when base is same, powers get added, m plus n, they This is m, take as this is m, this is n, implies that 11 plus 7 is equals to 29 raised to the power 18 is your answer. So always check that whether the base is same or not, or whether power is same or not. Now moving to the next law, that was when base is same and both the bases are divided, base is same but power is different. So the law was x to the power m minus n. Now moving to the this type of law, take an example, any example, you can take the previous example also. 29 raised to the power 11 divided by 29 raised to the power 7. Now in this law, the base is same, powers are different, but both the bases are now divided, but in the previous law both the bases are multiplied. So in this case, 29 raised to the power 11 minus 7 gives you the answer as 29 raised to the power 4. This is your answer. So always check that whether 29 raised to the power 11 divided by 29 raised to the power 7 having the same base or not. If they are having the same base but the different powers and they are coming in the divided form, always divide the first base upon the second base, that is 29 raised to the power 11 minus 29 raised to the power 7 gives you the answer as 29 raised to the power 4. Now moving to the next law, law number 3, which was when both the bases are different but the powers are same. Now both the bases are different but the powers are same. Now take an example as 7 raised to the power 3 multiplied by 6 raised to the power 3. You can take any type of example you want. It is not essential that you take these type of examples. You can even take the example of a negative number. Well, I'll take these type of examples also, so that you don't get confused that exponents and the bases should also be in terms of positive. They can also be negative. As I told you earlier, x is a real number quantity, powers are also real number quantity, but the constant is only is base should not be close to 0, because base having a 0 value is not defined in this case. So base should not be close to 0, because 0 is to the power any exponent value is not defined till now. So we will only check about the real numbers which are not equals to 0 about the base, and exponent power or index can be of any real number quantity. So is equals to 7 into 6 whole raised to the power 3 implies that 7 into 6 gives you 42 whole raised to the power 3 is your answer. No need to solve this value until now you are asked to solve, because if the options are in the terms of exponent only, because 42 raised to the power 3 is in terms of exponent and the option is asking to solve till this option only, so no need to solve beyond this level. Leave this till now and check whether the option is in the terms of exponent or in the form of numbers. If this 42 whole to power cube is in the form of number, then always apply the column law on the cube root method, which I'll discuss in the next chapter also. If you don't know about how to solve, then it is easy to solve that 42 multiplied by 42, use the square method which I told you earlier also. In column method, use 42 into 42 as a square method in the column method, then take the answer and then multiply this answer with the 42 value and then get your desired number. Now moving to the next law, take example number 4 as x to the power m divided by y raised to the power m is equals to x upon y होल रेज टू द पावर एम इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स अपॉन वाई. टेक एन एग्जाम्पल एज 7 रेज टू द पावर 6 अपॉन 14 रेज टू द पावर 6. नाउ यू कैन सी दैट बोथ द बेसिस आर डिफरेंट बट द पावर्स आर सेम. सो इज इक्वल्स टू वी कैन चेक दिस इज इक्वल्स टू शोज दैट 7 अपॉन 14 दिस होल एक्सप्रेशन कैन बी टर्म इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पावर 6 इज इक्वल्स टू 7 into 2 gives you 14, gives you the answer as 1 by 2 whole raised to the power 6. So this expression is termed in the form of exponent form, that is 1 by 2 raised to the power 6 is your answer. When 7 raised to the power 6 divided by 14 raised to the power 6 was solved, we get the answer as 1 by 2 whole raised to the power 6. So till now we have discussed about the four laws of exponent. Moving to the next law, that is law number 5. Law number 5 is x raised to the power m whole raised to the power n gives you the answer as x raised to the power m into n. As I told you earlier also while explaining this law, x to the power m to the power n is equals to x to the power m into n implies that when exponent power is also expressed in the term of whole power, then both the powers get multiplied simultaneously with the having the same base. For example, if you take 99999 whole raised to the power 7 and this expression is having also a power of 9, implies that this expression can be termed as 99999 whole raised to the power 7 multiplied by 9 is equals to, this expression can be termed as 99999 whole raised to the power 63 is your answer. So you have seen that x to the power m, where in this case it was 999999 raised to the power 7, and the whole expression also again raised to the power n, which was in that case was 99999 whole raised to the power 7, and this whole expression was also again raised to the power 9, gives you the answer as 99999 whole raised to power 7 into 9 gives you the answer as 5 times 9 whole raised to power 63 is your answer. We will take some more examples on this law only because it is a very essential law. Some more examples we will take, like 7 raised to the power 11 again raised to the power 9 gives you the answer as 7 raised to the power 11 multiplied by 9 gives you the answer as 7 multiplied by raised to the power 19 is your answer. So always check that whether the expression is coming in the form of power or not. Now moving to the last law of this laws of exponent. Last law of the laws of exponent is any real number when it is having a power of 0, then always this number gets converted into 1. Now let's check. The last law was x raised to the power 0 to power 1 implies that always check whether the base having a power of 0 or not. We will take some examples. We will take a very long number 10100000 whole raised to the power 0. Since the power is 0, this whole expression can be termed as in terms of 0, and this whole expression gives you the answer as 1. We will take some more example also. This is a very important example which was asked in the NTSC exam also. 3 raised to the power 0 प्लस 7 raised to the power 0 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 5 raised to the power 0. नाउ एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर ऑल्सो, एनी नंबर हैविंग द पावर एज 0 देन 3 raised to power 0 कैन बी टर्म्ड एज 1 बिकॉज एनी नंबर इज हैविंग अ पावर ऑफ 0 इज 1 प्लस 7 raised to power 0 gives you the answer as 1 multiplied by 1 implies that this whole expression becomes 2. 1 plus 1 is equals to 2 and multiplied with 1 gives you the answer as 2. So always check that whether the question is asking that plus or multiplied sign, because that time the students were very settled about this question because they give the answer as 1 because they see all the ones are coming, and in the terms of getting higher marks they get confused, and many times question was asked like this and the answers was given by a student was 1. So it is not like that. Always check whether 1 plus 1 is coming or 1 into 1 is coming, because if the question is like 1 into 1 into 1 gives you the answer as 1, but in this case 1 plus 1 into 1 is coming, so the answer is 2 into 1 is equals to 2. Now we will understand the last law of this chapter, that is the last topic of our chapter, is law of inverse. Now moving to the law of inverse, is law of inverse shows that if x raised to the power minus 1 is always equals to 1 by x. For example, 3 raised to the power minus 99 is equals to 1 by 3 whole raised to the power 99. I'll take another example which is quite a very confusing example. 1 by 2 whole raised to the power minus 1 by 2. So always go step by step. First of all, convert this in the 1 by 2 whole raised to the power 1 by 2 form. Then, as I told you earlier also, form of 1 by 2 is a square root form. So this term can be written as like this. Again, solving this term, it is equals to 1 upon 1 upon root 2, because root 1 is 1. This root 2 goes to the numerator side and this answer coming will be as 2, root 2. So always check whether the question is asking in the terms of positive powers or the negative powers. This question was asked also in the NTSC stage 1 examination. So see, these basic questions were also asked in the NTSC. So you can check that laws of exponents takes a major portion of your mathematics. So always have a good command on these type of topics. So till now, students, we will discuss some more examples in our next chapter of laws of exponents. So till now, have a good day. Thank you very much.